Dear presidents, dear hosts, dear friends, as the moderator mentioned, I'm here to speak on behalf of Mrs. Sonia Sten. She regretfully had a delay on her plane from her home place, so she couldn't make it for this opening session. She is very sorry for this, and she asks me to send her greetings for all of you. Nevertheless, this unfortunate event allows me to be the one welcoming you all on behalf of the Committee 3 to this summer academy here in Serbia. And it also gives me the opportunity to thank the host region and the organizers for preparing such an interesting program for us. I wish to underline that I'm more than happy that what Vojvodina proposed for this year's topic on the culture and the multicultural understanding, it's a topic that is so much at center of the Committee 3's work. In March of this year, Committee 3 held our plenary in the beautiful city of Novi Sad, and we attended a very interesting conference on the topic Culture for All. And this visit in Novi Sad, it gave us a good taste of what this summer academy will present, an interesting mix of lectures, workshops, and site visits. This time, we will have a full week for discovering in detail the rich cultural variety of this region. And I think that you can find only few places in Europe where you have so many ethnic groups and different cultures living peacefully together, using so many languages in day-to-day life. The province of Vojvodina should be designated as a symbol of respect and cohesion within a true diversity of people. Now, by sharing the best practice and good experience, by going to the different workshops and doing informal networking, both in daytime and in the evenings, as I already had a chance to see yesterday, how people meet, how people communicate, and how well we do together. We can all be assured to learn a lot during this week and to return home with many new contacts and many new ideas for our future work. For many of us in the regions, culture is one of the big priorities, be it through direct or indirect regional competences, and even through culture, be it cultural heritage, cultural production, or even the cultural identity, is put at risk nowadays due to the current economic situation. But culture is also an important tool for economic growth, and we can never forget to put our efforts into the culture. Because culture is about all the essence of a region and the identity of its society with its lifestyle, its languages, its heritage, and its know-how. I am also, again, very happy to see the involvement of the Youth Regional Network. Whenever or wherever AER meets, and where it's possible, the president of the YRN, Beate Rohner, and other members of the Youth Regional Network participate actively in our events. And by doing so, they also shape these events and give a voice to the young people throughout Europe who live in the societies and show them that active youth participation is possible and makes sense. And we should always remember that Europe, that we know it, belongs to the youth. I invite you all to think about the added value you can gain in your regions when you involve the youth and the young people in the regional political structures. From what I know already, the majority of the AER member regions already established some kind of youth parliaments or councils, or they work with independent youth institutions. But I would like to use this opportunity also to call upon those who haven't established any youth body yet. Look at the work they are doing within the AER and its youth regional network, and you will have an idea of what you can gain when working with young people throughout your regions. I would also like to close this by wishing you all a fruitful week, very nice discussions, and I hope by the end of the week we will go home with plenty of new ideas to share with all our colleagues and partners. Thank you very much.